ANS supported to reclaim the land that got affected because of the salination. And what Revati believes is that farmers are more inclined to listen to organic farming practice in disaster-struck areas, because otherwise they are like in disaster-struck areas there is no chemical farming solution. Like he said, the government writes it off. So there is no chemical farming solution. So that's the ideal place for traditional and organic farming to take place. And this is what Revati had grasped. And her impact in tsunami areas was such that Bill Clinton recognized Revati's contribution by the Indian government did it. And he saw Revati doing such good work in Tamil Nadu that he said she should immediately go to Sri Lanka, which was also tsunami affected. And the Sri Lankan government, because she came with Bill Clinton's recommendation, empowered her to work with various Sri Lankan farmers. But the Indian government did nothing of this kind to Revati. And what Revati says is that the reason she's been able to reach Cyclone Ayla and other places in India where she is because of aid. So aid did to Revati what Bill Clinton and the Sri Lankan government did to her for Sri Lanka. We have done to her for India. So now whenever disaster strikes, and there are farmers have issues, she's one of our major experts to help them. So she's helped the flood affected in Andhra Pradesh recently, the cyclone affected in West Bengal, the tsunami affected in Tamil Nadu, and so on. And she's really a very hearty person. She had come to the aid conference in Seattle, right?
Yeah.
She was here like 2 years ago, we invited her here. And she gave, maybe they have a recording of her speech. She's a very good speaker too.
So it's
primarily in the US, but in India, our education program, Eureka program, it raises quite a bit of money. And some chapters of India, like Aid Delhi, they raise money. So some of the Aid India groups are concentrating only on the work in the villages, and they kind of get rent from the US. Some chapters are also raising funds in India. So our program, for example, the education program in Tamil Nadu is affecting about 10,000 schools and almost about a million students. They have over 1 or 2 crore rupees annual budget. And they spend much more money than what aid.